and thank you for tuning in to the Shark Tank, Busan Foreign School's student-produced news program. I'm Diana Liu.
And I'm Subin Bae. The holiday season is here once again. This means that BFS is heavily involved in the local Busan community. Each year, faculty and students volunteer at the Biwa Christmas Bazaar. It's a giant celebration for foreigners that raises money for various charities. The BFS National Honor Society volunteered and raised a ton of money, and Mr. Chapa also brought many student musicians to perform. It was awesome.
The annual Christmas pageant was on Tuesday, December 10th at Shinsege. What a fantastic night! Thank you so much to the BFS staff and students for coordinating the event, and of course, to their parents for their support. The Shark Tank caught up with some Christmas pageant participants to see how people enjoy the event.
So I think the Christmas pageant was a lot better this year than the previous years because, well, first of all, it was a lot quicker. It ended a lot earlier than normal. And because in the past, the pageant has gone on for like half an hour to an hour longer than planned. So it was a lot more efficient. And also, I think adding jazz band sort of spiced up the whole program because it wasn't as like formal. And it was a lot more interesting because you don't see a lot of jazz band in Korea. Also, of course, Mr. Chapa and Dr. Kim's hard work paid off a lot this year, along with the performers, because it's not easy to perform in front of a crowd. So, yeah, I think we improved a lot this year.
Like, everybody likes Christmas, and like, everybody loves to celebrate and hear lots of a lot of music about it. I like preparing because I like playing violin.
Looks like the Christmas pageant was a lot of fun. Our second graders have been working on something exciting as well. Their first music video featuring the song If You Want to Sing Out, Sing Out came out 2 weeks ago. Let's hear what Ms. Schmidt and one of her students have to say.
I try to pick songs that have a positive message that reinforce the kinds of things I want my students to be working on. So this song is about being free to be yourself, and I want my students to know who they are and appreciate that. It was super fun. We start every day with a song, and I think it's a really good way to make sure, even if people have a problem on the bus or they lost their homework, when we come in the morning, we're going to do this song. It's really fun, and it helps put people in a good mood. Oh, it was super fun. I loved the green screen, and it was really impressive. The MMJ class took my idea and made it even better with the background and stuff, and the kids were really excited to be in a high school class.
I like the rainbow background because there are many different colors and sparkles. And the song was well. We did many different kinds of things like standing up and sitting down and like being free or just like doing stuff want to do, what you want to do. And I try our best. I like singing because singing has lots of different kinds of voices.
Ms. Schmidt's class worked really hard. You can watch the full video on the BFS TV YouTube channel. Stay tuned, we'll be right back after a short commercial break.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Shark Tank. Our international correspondent, Alexa Mikhenkova, has another exciting segment for you. Alexa is from Russia, so she wants to share some Russian culture with you. Let's check it out.
Hello, global citizens. I'm Alexa, and today I'm going to teach you a little bit of Russian.
Well, let's pretend you're in Russia and someone is walking by and saying «Привет». Don't be surprised, it just simply means «Hi».
«Привет». «Привет». «Поспорить тяжело,
мы с тобой вместе». Now, we are going to learn how to say bye in Russian. It's a little bit tricky, so let's try our best to pronounce it correctly.
Пока. Пока.
Ты вечно говоришь, что все непросто, нет. Зачем об этом думать? Это же сведет с ума. Как льется через занавес и лунный свет. Так льется и любовь, и я, и ты, и вся земля. Не думай, что все может вдруг пойти не так.
You need to know how much something costs. So, we're going to learn how to say it.
Сколько? Сколько? Стоит? Стоит? Сколько стоит?
For this edition of Shark Tank Sports, we will highlight a beloved athlete at BFS, Jeff Yu. Jeff has played several sports over the years. He mentors younger players, has been voted Athlete of the Year by his coaches, and he is an all-around integral part of our entire sports program. Let's find out what makes Jeff Yu so exceptional.
I fell in love with sports when I was a young little boy. I think when I was young, I played in a soccer team in elementary school. And after that, I fell in love with soccer and I play soccer every day with my friends. When I first came to BFS, I didn't know that BFS had lots of school events, sports events, I mean. And BFS had cross-country, basketball, and volleyball, soccer, those. And also they had some big tournament, also SCAC, and that kind of interested me. The biggest challenge I faced was my body, because I'm not like flexible as Alex. I'm not like fast sprinter like Steve. So I think those were my biggest challenge. And I not only practice in the school, I did some extra workout at home, like do some push-ups and do some endurance running at home at the running machine. So I think I'm not only respectful to the older people, I think I'm also being respectful to the younger kids, like to the kindergartners or elementary school. My advice is just if you're not, even though you're not good at sports, be confident and try your best in every practice. In the future, I want to make my own soccer team to play with for fun or whether it's a soccer club or university soccer team. As I said it before, just be confident, try your best, and never give up.
Tara Bay is back with another teacher interview. She'll now introduce you to Mr. Gates.
Testing, hello. I would say that a good math student isn't any different than a student that does well in any other subject. To be successful in anything, you just have to have a positive attitude and a strong work ethic. And if you have those two qualities, not only in school or anything else you do in life, you'll be successful. What would I be doing if I was not a math teacher? Probably still something with math. I mean, if you're good at something, you might as well stick with it. So I don't know, maybe an actuary, or ideally I'd like to be a statistician for some type of professional football team, or maybe basketball. What do I like that's not related to math? It's almost impossible to answer because everything in life is related to math, isn't it? Something very interesting about myself. I am almost half Korean, which isn't too far off because actually my younger brother, when he was born, he had a Mongolian spot. So there is some Asian blood in me, you could say. So what makes me different than the other teachers? Not a whole lot, but I guess I would have to say I wear the best socks out of any of the teachers in the school. For example, right now, I'm wearing banana socks. I've enjoyed my time here at BFS and look forward to the rest of the year. See you. See you later. Thanks for the interview.
Thank you for tuning in to this episode of The Shark Tank. We will leave you with video of the fifth graders singing the new school fight song. Mr. Chapa wrote the song and students have been singing it at our home basketball games this year. Enjoy the video and see you next time.